The anterior approach to hip replacement is really the most sophisticated way to perform a total hip replacement. With the hip joint is a ball and socket joint. It's normally in its undiseased state, covered with smooth articular cartilage. And that allows the femur to move in relationship to the hip. As you develop arthritis, a simplified way of looking at it is that the cartilage wears off and becomes rough, and you end up often with two bones from the hip and the acetabulum grinding together. And this causes pain and stiffness and often a limp. Technology has allowed the significant improvements in the prosthesis over the years. And more recently, with the anterior approach, we've improved the surgical technique, which allows your hip to be stronger, decreases your chance of limp and dislocation. So with the anterior approach, we go through a true intramuscular internervous interval. I mean, it means we don't disrupt the nerves, which make the muscles work, and we also don't damage the muscles. So by going through this plane, it's the one way to disrupt the anatomy the least while doing a total hip replacement. With the posterior approach, we usually split the gluteus maximus, a large muscle in your buttock, and that can partially denervate the gluteus maximus, which would leave it weaker after surgery, which could contribute to a limp. With the lateral approach, you also split the gluteus medius muscle and potentially could injure the superior gluteal nerve. But with the anterior approach, after surgery, all your muscles have the potential to work the way they did before surgery. And this allows people to recover faster and actually have a better functional result with less chance of dislocation.
The anterior approach to the hip is not a new approach. It's been done for years. It may have been actually one of the first approaches to the hip. But the anterior approach for total hip arthroplasties has been done for decades in Europe. In the 1990s, a Dr. Mata down in Los Angeles, he had one patient that had his done in Europe and wanted another one done. So he explored this approach and found it to be have many advantages over the posterior approach. We started El Camino Hospital. We started doing this approach about 7 years ago. And over that period of time, have done over 800 anterior approaches to the hip, which probably makes us the leader in anterior approaches to the hip in Northern California.
The main difference is that the dislocation rate is at least 10 times lower. If you look at the dislocation rate when you perform the procedure through the back, through a posterior approach, it's approximately 3 to 5% nationally. And if you do it through the front, through an anterior approach, it runs between 0.3 to 0.8%. So it's about 10 times lower.
Once we get into the joint and start putting in our components, we also have the advantage, because the patient is laying on its back as opposed to being on its side, we can use x-rays during the case, actually fluoroscopy. This helps us with positioning of the components as well as making sure that our leg lengths are equal. We will actually break scrub at the end of the case and measure the leg lengths just to ensure that the leg lengths are equal.
By doing the anterior approach, we don't have to do any precautions after surgery. If you do a posterior approach for 3 months, you have to be very careful not to sit in low chairs or on low toilet seats, not to bend over past 90 degrees at the hip, and not to cross your legs. When we do an anterior approach, there are no hip precautions from day one. So the return to normal activities is very different from person to person. Some people are able to return to work within 2 to 3 weeks, but it depends on the type of job that they do. If they have a very physical job or a job where they have to stand for a long period of time, that can take up to 6 to 8 weeks. If they're performing a desk-type job, they can return usually within 2.5 to 3 weeks. As far as recreational activities, most of the golfers or tennis players can return within 6 to 8 weeks. But there's variation from person to person. When patients come into my office, they often ask, why do we do this? And one of the main things that I tell them is that I've had over 40 patients where I performed a posterior approach on one hip, and then they came back years later to have their second hip done on the opposite side, and we performed the procedure through an anterior approach. Those people all came back to tell us that this was anywhere from 4 to 5 times easier to recover from. So it was a major force and influence in determining that this was the right thing to do for our patients.